Impact Observatory is a mission-driven company bringing AI algorithms and data to environmental management, sustainability, and risk analysis.
We look at different types of land cover and how it changes through time. So you can think of things like deforestation or wildfire monitoring, really any natural resource management purposes. Our goal is to empower decision makers with the timely, actionable insights that they need. Satellite imagery tends to be difficult for just anybody to interpret, so we have artificial intelligence algorithms to take raw pixels and turn them into actionable information. We have more satellite imagery now than we've ever had before, and cloud computing, like what we've used on Azure to process all of this imagery.
To build the land use land cover map, we utilized Open Geospatial Standards, Azure Batch, Microsoft Planetary Computer, and Azure Blob Storage is where we housed, wrote, and read our land use land cover predictions as we ran the pipeline and processed the data. But Azure Batch was really the workhorse behind our pipeline to build this land use land cover map. We processed data for not only the entire globe, but for each location on the globe, we actually processed a stack of data.
What it's really providing is a very flexible and dynamically reconfigurable cluster system where you can really dial in the processing capabilities that you need for the job that you want to perform. It's a highly flexible HPC platform.
We tried other cloud computing resources and were not able to effectively create what we wanted to create.
We did a lot of initial tests with different machines to get a sense of what resources we needed to run our tasks, what CPU we needed, what memory we needed. The standard D4 V2s really gave us the resources we needed to complete the tasks efficiently.
The Azure tools allowed us to process the entire globe in less than a week, which was a real feat of engineering. It was over 450,000 satellite images, 500 terabytes of data.
I think a high accuracy is obviously a key indicator, and we achieved that with 85% accuracy. A key indicator for me personally was seeing like the excitement of folks in the geospatial and the scientific world about the release of this map.
We definitely needed Azure to run as efficiently as we create timely insights and run this in near real time. And to do that, we really do need the high performance computing. We would not be able to do what we have done without Azure.